In at number 15 is... I'll be kidding.
Live so long with my eyes on me. Too deaf, too hear, too blind to see. Broken hearts on the city streets, but I can hear that you're calling me to be the hope, be the light, be the love right now. Starting right now.
Morning, everybody. I know I'm a bit late with the old Transformers top 15 of 15, but here we go. I'm going to go straight into it. Starting at the top of the pile at number 15 is Transformers Prime, Optimus Prime Weaponizer version. Which is a nice big leader size figure that has like some guns that poke out the top of it and it lights up. In truck form, it looks fabulous from the front, and it's got a few issues when it comes to the actual trailer part of it. It's a bit kibbly, but apart from that, it's a fantastic piece of kit. Next in is Transformers Generations Rhinox, which is something I didn't particularly want to get. My little lad, he vetoed me, and he wanted to go down the route again in this. After picking it up, transforming it, absolutely adored it. Glorious transformation. Really, really clever bit of engineering. Again, from one of the bargain shops. Very, very cheap. In next is Transformers Age of Extinction Galvatron. Now, this is the one with the funny little gimmick where you pull the... pull his chest out and it spins. It does spin. There we go. But one of the best things about this, two things really. One is the fact that it transforms into a really, really nice truck. The truck form of it is fantastic. Really, really good. And it's the price. It's £5.99 from the bargain shops. Phew. And there's still loads of these things knocking about. So get down there and get one bought. Next in is... Star Wars crossover. I know people hate these things, but I love this thing. It's an absolutely glorious it's a glorious piece of plastic, and it transforms into the best representation of an Imperial shuttle you'll ever see. And the robot form isn't that bad. I've got a real soft spot for these Transformers Star Wars crossover things. I don't care if people don't like them. I'm still liking them, so there you go. In next is Wheeljack from Transformers Prime. There's two versions of him here, so you can see what the car form looks like. And there's a, even though this is the Beast Wars version, this is the normal Transformers Prime version. I love this thing. And this mold has been used over and over and over again. It's a really, really, really good mold. And I cannot, and if you hold it and transform it, you'll understand why. It is fabulous. Next is Transformers Prime. Sorry about this, loads and loads of Transformers Prime, but trust me, they'll be gone soon. Transformers Prime Bludgeon and Shockwave. These guys are very, very similar. They are lovely in bot form. They just look so majestic and powerful. And the tank forms of them are not to everybody's taste, but I like it. I think it's a really, really nice thing. And again, you can pick them up from various shops. I've seen these really, really cheap. You probably pick them up for about £5 from the bargain shops. Great buy. In next is... Beast Wars Optimus Primal Transmetal version. This one transforms into a gorilla that rides on a hoverboard. What's not to love? And it was from a charity shop and it only cost me £1. In next is Human Alliance Skids, which is glorious. Really, 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 really nice. Fantastic transformation, a grown-up transformer, because it's complicated. It's got some real articulation about it. It looks fabulous. Ugh. Get one bought. If you need to get one of these things, the Human Alliance formers, in my opinion, are one of the best things that Transformers have ever done. In next is Transformers Armada Galvatron. Now, this guy has got... I've got a real soft spot for this guy in my heart, because... it didn't cost me very much, and I got the antlers made for me by a fellow YouTuber. Oh, it just looks so good. It's ratchety. It's simple to transform. It just looks the business on your shelf. And in my opinion, one of the greatest things that you can ever buy and put on your shelf is one of these guys, either the Megatron version or the Galvatron version. get one found. Next is the last Transformers Prime, I assure you, which is Transformers Prime RC. Gorgeous little Transformer, really, really clever. It's just, it transforms into a fabulous bike, a fabulous robot, and it was a gift, so that makes me happy. Next is Transformers Human Alliance Bumblebee. Still got the pea head. I don't want to change the head. I'm going to keep the head as a pea. It is a great bot, this thing. I never get any of the instructions for these Transformers when I buy them on the car boots. This was like the best puzzle in the world. I sat there for hours and hours and hours working out, and then just finding like little things, like found out the knees flipped out and all the rest of it. Oh, you need to find one of these guys. I've actually got two now. I've got one that sits on my desk at work, because normally I don't buy Transformers twice, but it's that damn good. I bought one twice just so I could have one sat on my desk at work so I can fiddle with it. In at number four is Generation Springer. Not as high up as you thought he was going to be, is he? He is a glorious bot. Reviewed him recently. Well, I didn't review him recently. I recently picked him up and got him for Christmas. He is amazing, but he's not as good as the other three. In at number three is... I've got to push them back a little bit. Leader class movie version Optimus Prime. This thing is so complicated and so fun. It still has all its working bits and bobs. It's just, a fantastic piece of plastic. The fact that it has articulated fingers and it has little chunks on it, and it's just so good. And the truck form when you've transformed it is nice and heavy, and it feels like real quality. It's just a glorious piece of plastic. In at number two is Dark of the Moon Shockwave. Again, this was another gift, but this thing, gushing and gushing and gushing and gushing for ages and ages I wear over this. Absolutely adore it. It's so majestic and evil and macabre looking in its robot form. And the tank form is quite, it's not everybody's taste, but I really, really like it. But in robot form, you give me another Transformer that looks this good in robot form. And it's that, and this top 15 is so good. It kept out some fantastic bots like Transformers Prime, Megatron and things like that. So that brings me on to my number one Transformer of the year. And this goes to one thing that I found quite early on in my hunting days. And I found it, and it cost me the grand total of 50 pence. And it is Ghost Starscream, one of the Takara versions, I believe it is. Or is it Hankai? I don't know what it is. It's a very, 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 very nice thing made of clear plastic. And like I say, it cost me 50 pence. Didn't know what it was to begin with when I picked it up. This woman obviously didn't know what it was. It was absolutely filthy. I love this thing. It is gorgeous. So thank you. Thank you for watching my top 15 of 2015. Have a great new year. I'll see you all later.